"You know I'm not a Jew," Pilate said. "Your own people and the chief priests brought you to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom doesn't belong to this world. If it did, my followers would have fought to keep me from being handed over to our leaders. No, my kingdom doesn't belong to this world." "So you are a king," Pilate replied. "You are saying that I am a king," Jesus told him. "I was born into this world to tell about the truth. And everyone who belongs to the truth knows my voice." Pilate asked Jesus, "What is truth?" Pilate went back out and said, "I don't find this man guilty of anything. And since I usually set a prisoner free for you at Passover, would you like for me to set free the king of the Jews?" They shouted, "No, not him. We want Barabbas." Now Barabbas was a terrorist. Those words come from John chapter 18, verses 35 to 40. That day, 2,000 years ago, the people shouted that they would rather have a terrorist running free in their society than Jesus Christ. Jesus had healed the sick, given sight to the blind, and even raised the dead. But his very life convicted the world of their sin and rebellion against God. So the crowd would rather have terrorists operate freely than have God's man in this world. Years have passed, but the crowd still cries for Barabbas and wants to put Jesus back on the cross. Today, terrorists are ignored, excused, justified, and even praised, while followers of Jesus are blamed for all that is wrong in this world. Never forget that if you are a follower of Jesus and living this life as Jesus did, you will be treated the same as Jesus was. The world around you would rather have terrorists than you. You will not be praised by men for your faithfulness to God. Lord Jesus, forgive me for desiring the praise of men more than your love and approval. May this day be one of seeking you with all my heart, no matter what may come my way. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.